Today we're working on the Greenwich Anniversary Sewing Patchwork, or GASP for short. What we've done is we've created a big heart with the 25, like the logo that's been used for the 25th anniversary, and we've drawn it up on big canvas and cut it all up into squares. So people come in and they pick up a section, and they just sew little embellishments all on it in the colours, and then eventually it'll just be sewn into a big heart, similar to one we did for Valentine's Day here, but it will have the 25 in the middle, and it should be good.
So, here we go. With hope and expectation, I hereby declare the new marking clock open.
Very proud, yeah. Worth 25 year wait. Hopefully it'll see another 25 years.
How many man hours of work went into it?
2 months. I've been doing it in between making the clocks, and so I don't really know. I didn't even time it. One misact.
What was that?
I glued one bit up and dropped it.
You're kidding.
Yeah, then I recut it all down, playing it all back up again. But it wasn't together, it was a queue. I was a bit dubious standing under there with the MP, but originally we come to have a shop, and then they said they wasn't sure whether they were going to have it, so we said, well, we'll have a stall, and then they had the shop, so we just stayed here, and that's where it is 25 years later.
Greenwich Market is very special. It's a vibrant market with a range of different stalls and shops around the outside. It's evolved over the years. It's very different now to what it was 200 years ago when it first started. And the arts and craft emphasis of the last 25 years has clearly been a very big success. But that needs also to be supplemented by food, which has been brought in as a feature in the last couple of years. And the market will undoubtedly change over the coming years, but it's got to be kept vibrant and characterful as it is now. And if we can achieve that, I'm confident that Greenwich Market will continue to be a major attraction for the people of Greenwich and for visitors.
Today we're doing a kids' workshop, so the kids can all join in. It's very interactive. They basically make beaded items, so bracelets, necklaces, key rings, keychains. It's really nice because they get to explore their creativity and work with colours and shapes and things. So.
And it's something you do quite often in the market.
We do it when there's occasions and festivities and things down here. Like today's the 25th anniversary, so it's an ideal time because it brings people into the market. The thing I love about Greenwich Market is it's very diverse, it's very artistic,
and you
find it's very loud. Lovely music. But you get people from all different, backgrounds and walks of life, and they all come down and get a chance to join in and be artistic, basically.
Once, twice, three timing mobbits at 55. So to was it you, sir?
It's so creative. The people, it is such a creative place to be. You'll find the most hard-working, creative, and really loyal people to this market, and they're friends for life. 25 years here, it's been a pleasure.
We've had great support from locals, from visitors, from people from outside of the area, inside the area. That's one of the reasons we chose to be a Greenwich Market, because it's got good, amazing local support.
Yeah, I think it has really a very, very good mixture, because of course it is really also one of the main tourist attractions in London. So we've got lots of visitors from the rest of the UK, visitors from abroad who come to Greenwich, and are also part of our customer base.
We sell clothing from the 1840s up to about the 1980s. We do quite a lot of 30s, 40s and 50s clothing.
What's your favourite piece in the shop at the moment?
I think it's that 20s dress hanging on the wall up there, which is quite unusual, 1920s, yeah.
And tell us obviously you've got your keep calm and carry on poster. Are you keeping calm and carrying on?
Definitely keep calm and carry on.
And you like it here at Greenwich Market?
Oh yes,
we love it.
Yeah, we do love it here.
Yeah, we love it.
Shea butter is a natural plant product grows in Africa. It's indigenous to Western East Africa. And it's been found to have amazing properties. It's very nourishing to the skin because it's rich in vitamins. It's also rich in fatty acids. In fact, it has more than cocoa butter, coconut oil and olive oil put together. It also has amazing properties that makes it very healing and good for skin conditions like eczema, psoriasis, dermatitis, acne, stretch marks and scarring. And it's very effective. I've got lots of great customers who've used it and have actually worked on them.
Been in Greenwich Market for 2.5 years, had the label for 4 years. My label is called Seeker. We produce all our collections in Ghana. They're all produced by local seamstresses and tailors. Yeah. Going to Ghana on a regular basis as a child, my mum used to force me to go on holidays there, and I always hated it, but at the same time had a love for the prints and the culture. And when I started to get a bit older, I started appreciating it a bit more and thought it'd be amazing to marry the two cultures somehow. And so the label came about. We change the colours every season. Most of our prints are limited and exclusive, which means that if we only do maybe 50 of each, and most customers that have them kind of treasure them because they know that you're not going to see like 100 ladies wearing that dress or that print. So. Mm-hmm.
£2.36, please, Mr. Jones.